most people genuinely do want better outcomes in their life, or genuinely do want to change. Certainly, most people in this room are probably ambitious and want to achieve better things. It's not really that you don't want it. In my estimation, the real problem is if you're struggling to change, the problem isn't you. It's not that you don't want to change. You have the wrong system for change. The problem isn't you. The problem is your system. And in fact, I think we can even go a step further and say that you do not rise to the level of your goals, you fall to the level of your systems. You know, like this is one of the core ideas of the book, that so often we talk about change, particularly in business or any kind of competitive field, as you need to be bold, you need to have a better vision, you need to 10x your goals, you need to think bigger. But the truth is, having the goal is kind of the easy part. You know, like I can set a goal right now to sell 10 million books in 3 seconds. You know, like the goal is not the hard part. And in fact, if you look at the winners, so to speak, and the losers in most fields of life and most domains, they often have the same goals. Like if you've got, say, the British cycling team, or pretty much any sports league, you have 30 teams competing for the championship. Presumably, they all have the goal of winning the championship, right? Or if you have 100 candidates applying for the job, presumably every candidate has the goal of getting the job. And if the winners and the losers have the same goals, the goal cannot be the thing that makes the difference. So it may be necessary, but it's not sufficient for success. And in fact, we could say whatever your current results are in life, your current habits are perfectly designed to deliver them, by definition. Right? Whatever system you're running right now is perfectly designed to deliver the current outcomes. And so if there's ever, to bring this in more into like habit language, your goal is your desired outcome. And your system is the collection of daily habits that you're following. And if there's ever a gap between your desired outcome and your daily habits, if there's ever a gap between your system and your goal, the system will always win. The goal will always be pushed aside. The daily habits will always deliver the outcome they're designed to deliver. And so we also badly want our results to change. It's the thing we talk about all the time. We want to double our income or lose more weight or reduce stress. Like, we all want the outcomes to be different. But the truth is, most of your outcomes in life are a lagging measure of your habits. Your knowledge is a lagging measure of your reading and learning habits. Your physical fitness is a lagging measure of your eating and training habits. Your bank account is a lagging measure of your financial habits. Even like the clutter in your bedroom or on your desk at work is a lagging measure of your cleaning habits. And so if you want the outcomes to change, it's like fix the inputs and the outputs will fix themselves. Right? Change the habits that precede the result and you won't have to worry about it. And so the focus should be much more on the system. Now, ultimately, what we want, of course, is not to say goals are completely useless. What we want is for those systems that are going to be aligned, right, for those two to match up. And I think a useful question to ask yourself is, can my current habits carry me to my desired future? Because if they can't, then something needs to change.